hoping that, you know, diabetes is somehow a fat disease. I'm like, well, almost every type 2 diabetic that I know is severely obese. So let's start with that. That obesity on them is accumulated fat. Well, that's because they eat too much sugar. I don't think so. I mean, I know plenty of people who eat high carb, low fat diets. They don't get fat. It's usually the combination of high fat and high carb diets that lead to this rapid obesity. And not just any type of fat, but the type of fat that produces a chronic inflammatory response, which the PUFA, the polyunsaturated fats, are known for. They are the main precursors of the inflammatory mediators of the body. The pharmaceutical industry has spent billions of dollars developing drugs that inhibit the enzymes that synthesize inflammatory mediators from the polyunsaturated fats. Well, let's take it a step further. Why, instead of developing these drugs that inhibit enzymes, why not just limit the intake of PUFA, which will also have the effect of decreasing inflammation? The response you get is, you can't do that. The PUFA are essential. Without them, you die. Show me the evidence. Oh, yeah, here is a study from the 1930s. One study by a guy called Burr and his wife, who did one study with rats to basically see what happens if you deprive these rats of the polyunsaturated fats in the diet and you gave them fully saturated fats. So these rats became lean and their metabolic rate doubled. They couldn't get these rats to become obese, even though they fed them the calorie equivalent of 4 rats a day. So imagine instead of eating 2,000 calories, you eat 8,000 to 10,000 calories a day, and you continue losing weight. That's how fast their metabolism became. But they also noticed some symptoms such as dry skin, cracking skin, and basically really high body temperature, right? These are all, yes, undoubtedly signs of high metabolism, but it's because when you increase the metabolic rate, that also increases your dietary need for all of the cofactors that go into maintaining that body. So if you now have the metabolism that can metabolize 8,000 calories a day, guess what? You will need to increase pro rata your intake of minerals and vitamins and other nutrients probably at least 4 times to what you were taking before. And if you don't, which is what they did with those poor rats, then of course these rats are going to develop nutritional deficiencies. But those rats still were extremely resilient, and they had very hard time killing them because almost every animal experiment that tries to assess toxicity and or changes in health eventually ends up with the animals being killed by either like a blunt force trauma or like bleeding them or giving them like some kind of a suffocating gas. Well, guess what? I think they tried to kill them with some kind of a gas like carbon dioxide. The rats would just not die. They actually had this in the study, commentary to the study saying that the rats were extremely resilient to sacrifice. So I thought, wow, well, shouldn't that be a major finding of the study? Guess what? We removed the PUFA from the diet and these rats became impossible to kill. I think most humans would